Hello friends, welcome to Nick IT Academy. In this session, we are going to learn about parameter and variables. I have splitted this session into two different parts. First part, we are going to learn about parameters. Second part, we are going to learn about variables. So this is the agenda for today's session. So what is parameter? What is variable? What is the difference between parameter and variables? How to pass a value to a Informatica workflow or session through a parameter file? How to pass a different value in the next run, how to configure the parameter file in the runtime. So that we are going to learn with example. Whatever the concept I have explained in our session, I have given in the document. It is available in the descriptions. You can download the document for more details. If you haven't subscribed my channel, so please subscribe the channel. You'll be getting all the updates whenever I'm uploading the new videos. Let us start our session. So parameter and variable is nothing but if you want to pass any value dynamically to the mapping or dynamically to the session, we can give us parameter or variable. Okay. So what is parameter and what is variable? So everything will be maintained like a dollar symbol. If $2 is there, then this is like a mapping level parameter. Okay. This is mapping level parameter. Single dollar is there, then this is a session level parameter. Okay. Session level parameter. So you have seen something like $PMSRC file directory, right? $PMSRC file directory. It's nothing but file directory. It's nothing but it's a source file directory. You can see here. I think we have here. We should have. If you go here, the source is a file. Then you can see something like $PM source file directory. This is single param, single values there, right? It's nothing but $PM source file directory equal to the C drive Informatica, that path you have. Why they are giving like this? It's a parameterized value instead of hard-coded value. So if you are giving a hard-coded value, what will happen? If you are migrating your workflow into other environment, then that environment will not have this particular path. Okay. And also some particular path, if you are changing over the period of time, you have to change it all over the workflows. So instead of that, if you are giving us parameters, then definitely can able to give. So whenever it required, all right. So this is $PM level. It's a session level properties. And so what is the difference between parameter and variables? So for an example, you have the parameter. The parameter is nothing but you'll be having $. Okay. $ is the mapping level parameter, right? So parameter, it will not change during the runtime. Okay. It will not change value during runtime. And the session level parameters, okay, the session level parameters are the parameter. If I'm taking, for an example, $ on value I'm taking, okay, so something like I'm taking some value, any values I can take. For an example, I'm taking $ salary equal to 1,000 or 10,000 or anything. So during the runtime, it will not change. Okay, during the runtime, it will not change. So this is like parameter. So once it has taken the value throughout the session, that value will not change. But what is variable? During the runtime, it will change. Okay. So variable value will change. The value will change during the session run. May or may not change. Okay. So may change during the session runtime. So that means if you are giving some $ count, that value will be changed during the runtime also. So this is called parameters and variables. Okay. So like if you want to give like something like parameter and variable, you can go with, so dynamically, if you want to pass a value to the mapping, then you can go for either the parameter or variable. Variable is value will change during the runtime. The parameter will not change. So you can see the variable port also, right? You can see here, I'm going with something like parameter. So here I'm going to create a mapping called m_parameter. Okay, so m_parameter. There are two types of parameter values are there. One is global parameter, global, and one is local parameter. Okay, so what two types of parameters? What is global parameter? Global means any session, any workflow can read that. Okay, that is a global parameters. So any session or any parameter can read that value. But the local one is nothing but it's particular to the local to the that particular session. You have to mention that folder name, session name, and everything, then that value should be applicable for that session only. It is not applicable for other session. Okay, but you are defining a parameter or variable as global, then others can use it. So that is what the global variable. So you can go with something like, so this is the local variable. And you can see here, so look at here, I'm going to take one. So what it will do, it will automatically select all the records from the source. But I want to dynamically select the values from the source. Then I can go for something like parameters. You can, first you have to define that what parameter you want. You can go here, the properties, I'm just making that something like, even the SQL query also I can give it like parameter, but just I'm giving var class only in the parameter. Just is generating that SQL, okay. Generate it and give this var class as $$var. Something like $$var. I'm just giving us this var class is the $$var. If I'm not giving any value for this $$var, then null value will be passed here. So click on OK. What is $$var? First of all, we have to declare it. Go to mapping, go to parameter and variables, add a new parameter or variable. It'll ask you want to have $$var. That one we have used, right? So just I'm making the $$var. Whether it is a variable or parameter, it'll ask. So I can take it as parameter. So I do not want to change the value during the runtime. Mostly we will create a parameter only here. So string $$var will be like, I can give some 100 characters or 1000 characters. So its expression you can make like false. Okay, you can give okay. So you can make control yes, it should be valid now. Then go to the workflow. So you can create one workflow, new workflow. So WF underscore parameter, okay, parameters. So you can give session. So M underscore parameter, click on OK, then click on link task, double click on the task, go to mapping, source should be pointing to source, target should be pointing to target. Okay, you can go a little bit down, you can see truncate target table option, right? You can provide it and then you can apply, click OK. But we have provided a parameter, right? You can go to the C drive, where we can keep the parameter file. You can keep C drive, Informatica 10.2.0 server and InfraShad. You can go to the param file. This is the folder and go inside. You can create one file here, param. So any file name. So that file name we have to give here. So this is the path, right? You can see here, this is the path. In this path, we have the param.txt file. If you are using any parameter, you have to give the properties. The properties you can give parameter file name, right? It has one option called the parameter file name. There you have to mention the parameter file name. So click on parameter file name here. Just click on OK. So what is the file name? Param.txt. So that file name you have to give here. So click on apply. OK, that's all. So $$var we have to define here. Go to parameter file, double click on it. So you can mention like it's a global parameter. If it is a global, then you have to mention like this. And $$var, okay, it's a case sensitive. So $$var, you have to give like this. And you are giving var salary greater than 15,000. Just I'm making that var class. Then apply okay. So what Informatica will do? Informatica, while starting it, right? So if any parameter has been used, it will check the parameter file. It will go and read the parameter value. Since we have given us parameters $$var, it will read the data. Now look at here. So this is running. Informatica is running. Today I'm giving like $$var equal to var salary greater than something. But tomorrow I may give some different one. It got succeeded now. You can see it should have taken 3 records only. If you go to the file, the session log, you can see, so $$ value will be presented here from employees where salary greater than 15,000. That is the parameter value has been passed. Okay, so now you can see, go to this workflow, sorry, parameter file. I'm not changing anything in the session level or Informatica level. Just I'm changing the parameter value. Okay, so for example, where job underscore ID equal to SA underscore rep. So SA rep is nothing but sales representative. I'm just giving it. Job ID equal to this one. So I'm just making like, this is the parameter value. I haven't changed anything in the Informatica level. Just I have changed that parameter file. Go here, run, start or flow. You can see now the characteristics changed, right? Now it is reading 30. In most of the cases in real time, the connection value also parameterized. The connection value also parameterized. So this is like where job ID equal to this one. Okay. It's passing the runtime. It is passing the parameter value. Okay. So this is something like parameter, global parameter. You have to mention like global. If you want to give local parameter, you have to give this formula. For an example, so global is nothing but all integration service process can able to read that global parameter. So you can give this, this is the one normally we will follow. Okay, something like folder name. Okay, folder name, this is entire workflow level, folder name dot WF colon workflow name, or if we will give in this format, folder name dot WF underscore workflow name, worklet name or session name, or you will give this formula also, the session names. If you are giving like this, this is the named session, right? For that particular session, you have to give a value. So we have to give, for an example, you want to give for this folder, this session alone, you have to give like this. Instead of global, you have to give folder name will be, so this is a folder name, right? Training underscore five. So this is a folder name, dot workflow name. So this is the workflow name. This is session name. For this session, we are giving, right? So we have to give session name. This session name here, like this, we have to give. And so global, like I will remove it now. So training underscore five dot this workflow dot session name equal to this one. For this, we are passing. So now you can check whether it is able to read the parameter file. Okay, so 30 records is getting, right? So this is the way you have to give for the parameters. For some other parameter value, you have to give some other name. You can give some other name also. Any path you can mention, but you have to tell that Informatica that, okay, this is the path, this is the parameter file. The parameter name, the file names very correctly, okay? So if you are giving some different name, it will get failed. Even some real time, the parameter file also we will create runtime. Connection value, we will create runtime. So that is also possible. Here we are giving like this, right? But we will create the parameter file runtime also. That script will create the file. Some script will be there. So that script based on the value, it will create the file, okay? Use some script to run this particular workflow. So look at this. This is one of the wrapper script, something like bash script, right? Bash script you have. And then this is commented out. PM home is nothing but infra path. So infra path and infra server name. You have to give either dev, UAT or prod. Informatica domain, the domain name you have to provide. Workflow name, you have to give the workflow name. Informatica user, so what is the user you have to give. Password, you have to give the password. Workflow name, that workflow name you have to give. What is the workflow name you have? So start, then $PM home, that is nothing but, so this folder, right? You remember that Informatica folder. So Informatica 10.2.0 server, InfraShad. So here you'll be having that. This is the $home path. So it will be mentioned in the admin level. Then you are passing this one, PMCMD, then start workflow. These are all something like variable parameter passing. You have to give all this Informatica user, Informatica password, domain and everything, folder, wait time, workflow name, everything you have to give. So it will fetch the workflow status. So it will take the status, whether it is running or succeeded or failed. It will take, and then if the workflow status equal to zero, then it should show you like execution successful. Elif, we are making that execution has failed. Something like other than zero, we are getting some status like one or zero, something like that. One or some other value, then you may assume that, okay, this workflow got failed, right? So this is what you can take. This is one of the PMCMD command wrapper script to start the workflow. This is not to create a parameter file. So this is the way we will create normally the parameters and the variables.